there to protect our scientists. Every time you threaten a government, we will be there to fight for our freedom. There was someone from Honduras, and the coup in Honduras or the coup in Brazil, all these coups could be called Monsanto coups in our times. We know we've to get out of this. We know we'll be better off by getting out of this, these chains of poisons. There's a very simple set of transitions we must make. Our first transition is from fiction to reality. Every dominant category ruling us today is a fiction. GDP is a fiction. It's a construct. Capital is a construct. Even the gene as a force of determinant and the life force that determines all quality and traits in life forms, that's a fiction. The idea that it's a master molecule, even bigger fiction. They call it a master molecule. There are no masters in nature. There is just a family of relationships. The second transition is from a mechanistic reductionist science to an agroecological science based on relationships and interconnectedness. And all the real science is showing that actually produces more food and better food. And the only way to really produce food. Everything else is war. The poison cartel only has a war arsenal and a militarized mind to produce that arsenal. We will make peace with the earth through our bread. The third transition is from the seed as intellectual property of corporations to seed as living, diverse, evolving. To a seed as a commons, that's the source of our food and the source of life. That is why seed freedom. The fourth transition is from chemical intensification. Because every time they say intensification, people think, well, if you intensify something, there must be more output. When you intensify poison, the only thing you get more of is climate instability, disease, poverty, dead soils, extinction. The sixth extinction is being driven by industrial agriculture. 93% plant variety is gone, 75% bees gone, because we're using a poison arsenal. The fourth, intensification, chemical intensification to ecological intensification. From stupidity intensification and irresponsibility intensification. Because I think you have to be stupid to declare that destroying the life of the soil is a way to improve the soil. To destroy the web of insect relationships is the way to control pests. It is a stupidity that does not allow you to recognize how nature works. We need to move from that to intelligence, true intelligence. Linking to nature's intelligence and our own, and from monocultures to diversity. And Navdanya's work has shown over the three decades that with biodiversity, we can increase our food production and nutrition production and nourishment twofold in the world. The care for the earth and production of food is the same activity. And that's why when they come and say, oh, you know, the next thing we need is a few more drones to spray some more Roundup more efficiently. Or a few more drones to capture the data of soil. Well, the only data you can capture from the air, which you'll sell back as big data to the farmers as a new commodity and a new intellectual property, is data that doesn't see the life of the soil. It cannot see mycorrhizae. The drone is blind to the mycorrhizal fungi. And anything that doesn't understand the life of the soil is a blind technology. The web of life is a food web. We have an ancient text that says everything is food, everything is something else's food. And that's exactly how nature works. When you don't understand those relationships, and you just bombard with the crudest of chemicals that you can find. Not only are you giving poison food, you're disrupting the systems that make food production work. That was the heart of the IASTD report.